In the United States, one future looming disaster is the most well-known among the general populace and most frequently over-dramatized by Hollywood, the eventual future major earthquake on the San Andreas Fault, which is colloquially referred to as the Big One. This earthquake is expected to have a magnitude of between 7.8 and 8.3, with a 30% chance of such an event striking by 2054. Such a destructive earthquake is modeled to become the costliest natural disaster in not only the United States or even North America, but the entire Western Hemisphere. Specifically, if the Big One was to hypothetically occur tomorrow, it is modeled to cause $292 billion in damage, 1,900 deaths, 53,000 injuries, dozens to perhaps even hundreds of fires, and leave hundreds of thousands of people homeless. Such a disaster will dwarf both the destruction caused by the 1989 Loma Prieta earthquake and the 1994 Northridge earthquake. So, why will this earthquake eventually occur? First, the basics. While all of California is rightfully considered to be part of the continent of North America, from a tectonic standpoint, this is not actually the case. California is in fact split into two separate tectonic plates, where to the west 16.4% of the state's landmass is part of the planet's largest tectonic plate, the Pacific Plate, while the rest of the state is part of the North American Plate. These two tectonic plates are always moving, but the faults between them for the most part are not. As a result, overtime stress from the motion of the moving tectonic plate builds up on a fault line until it finally overcomes the friction between the sides of the fault, generating an earthquake. Since the 800-mile-long San Andreas Fault marks the boundary between these two tectonic plates and happens to accommodate 75% of their motion, the potential for very large buildups of energy and thus major earthquakes on this fault line exist. The two sides of the San Andreas Fault are not moving into or away from each other in a way that creates vertical motion like the vast majority of faults, but instead move in a horizontal manner where they slip past each other. In other words, while the average motion on the San Andreas Fault, which is a right lateral strike slip fault, varies, it tends to move at an average rate of 35 millimeters or 1.38 inches a year. The San Andreas Fault line is divided into three segments which have varying characteristics that define them, with these being the northern segment, the central segment, and the southern segment. While one, two, or all three of these segments could technically rupture during a major earthquake, generally speaking, only one segment ruptures during a large magnitude event. The northern segment stretches from just west of Cape Mendocino to the city of Hollister. It produces magnitude 7.8 plus earthquakes about once every 190 years, with these occurring in 1522, 1690, and 1906. This section of the San Andreas Fault is largely locked, meaning pressure could theoretically build up to produce a major earthquake. The good news, however, is that the last major earthquake was fairly recent. In contrast, the central section, which stretches from southwest of Hollister to the town of Parkfield, is not mostly locked, but instead is continuously creeping or altogether moving at a very slow rate. This in recent times has prevented very large earthquakes from occurring here, although this segment was once the site of a magnitude 7.8 or larger earthquake at some point in the last 2,000 years, so this behavior could be a fairly recent phenomena. And we can further subdivide this segment into two regions. The northern region has not produced any earthquakes larger than 5.5 in recent times and goes all the way to Bitterwater. However, between Bitterwater and Parkfield, especially around Parkfield, there have been fairly frequent magnitude 6.0 to 6.5 range earthquakes, and the reason for this is that some small locked sections do exist between the creeping segments. These quakes occurred around and northwest of Parkfield every 12 to 38 years, with the last such event striking in 2004. Now for the southern segment, which stretches from just southeast of Parkfield all the way to Bombay Beach. This region appears to have the potential to and has produced the largest earthquakes in the entire San Andreas Fault, producing five magnitude 7.8 plus earthquakes between 1100 and 1857. This region marks the most likely segment to produce the Big One people fear, and there are two candidate areas where this could occur. The northern region goes all the way down to Lancaster and produces magnitude 7-plus earthquakes fairly regularly within 140 years of each other. And yet, it has been 167 years since the last major earthquake occurred there. In contrast, there is still high, but slightly lower risk of an even larger earthquake occurring in the southern region, as it seems to produce larger magnitude events every 190 to 350 years, with the last major quake occurring all the way back in 1690, 334 years ago. Past major earthquakes in this section have been linked to periods when the ancient Lake Cahuilla was quite high, as this extra water added additional strain on underlying faults, while also sending water into gaps, lubricating fault lines and making it easier for them to slip. Yet, with only a very small and shrinking Sultan Sieh in recent years, the interval before the next earthquake appears to have been potentially pushed back slightly.